Welcome back to the Broker Corner, where we talk best practices, business tips, and current industry events. This time, we're going to be talking about the Sitzer Burnett trial and the verdict that unfortunately came out against the industry last month in October. Realtors, well, we lost. But instead of panicking and putting your head in the sand, I'm about to run down the top five things you should be focused on in this post-commission lawsuit world. Number one, be ready to explain the lawsuit to your clients. Almost every national headline has published a story about the commission lawsuit. So if you're on the phone with your next client or meeting them and they're more knowledgeable than you about the outcome, that's a red flag. Plus, there's tons of new copycat lawsuits that are being filed every day. So the cat's out of the bag, and this is gonna continue to be a topic of conversation for months to come. What does this mean? Your clients are definitely gonna have questions. You better have the answer. If you haven't done so already, make sure that you're receiving news updates from industry-related resources that truly explain what's happening with the lawsuits, how that's affecting our industry. Number two, you're gonna have to figure out how you're gonna get paid for your services. This should definitely be a no-brainer for most of us, but unfortunately, there's probably gonna be a few that make it to the closing table and find out that there may not be a commission check waiting for them. That's right, gone are the days, or at least the days to come, where your commission is guaranteed through the multiple listing services. Now, don't panic again just yet, because there haven't been any MLS rules changes that bars a cooperating agent from receiving commission from a listing agent, but writing's on the wall. As of the filming of this video specifically, our local multiple listing services, MLS Listings, has already issued a rule change allowing zero compensation to be offered to a buyer's agent through the multiple listing services. How can you protect yourself? Well, this is where you should be talking to your broker of record. This is a conversation you want to have with them to find out what their tips and best practices and processes are to ensure that you're going to get paid at the closing table. Number three, it's time to improve your buyer presentation and begin using a buyer broker agreement. When, more likely than if, commission is decoupled from the multiple listing services, you're gonna need to protect yourself and find out who's gonna be paying you through providing services to a buyer in a transaction. This is where a buyer broker agreement comes in. Think about it this way. You wouldn't take on a listing without a signed listing agreement guaranteeing the seller is gonna pay your commission, right? Well, the same thing is gonna be for working with a buyer client. This time, you're gonna have to set up what services you provide and exactly what fee the buyer will be paying for you representing them through the transaction. To me, this signals that now is the time to stop and reevaluate, to take a really good look at your current buyer presentation. Does it explain how buyer's agency works and the differences between being represented by a buyer's agent versus the listing agent? Does it explain how much compensation you're looking to be paid for providing your services? And does it identify or explain who specifically pays for your compensation? Does it clearly define your value proposition for the buyer? But most importantly, does it articulate the benefits that you'll be providing to the buyer in exchange for the compensation that you'll be owed through the transaction? If not, then you've definitely got some work to do. Number four. It's time to enhance your negotiation skills. Most successful agents are already highly skilled negotiators. In fact, that's one of the main traits that most clients look for in a really good agent who is there and available to negotiate on their behalf for the sales price and terms of the contract when they're making an offer or when they're accepting an offer when representing a seller. With these changes looming, this is definitely gonna be a situation in which you as the agent are gonna have to then pick up and negotiate who's gonna be paying your compensation as well. So if you feel that you need a refresher or some training, why don't we look at leveling up those skills now? What are some things you can do in this moment to help progress your negotiating skills? There are a few courses that are offered through the Realtor Association, which you can take, such as the Real Estate Negotiation Expert designation, as well as the Certified Negotiation Expert. Additionally, a few books that I would recommend picking up or at least listening to the Audible versions would be Never Split the Difference by Chris Voss, as well as the Harvard Business School's Book of Negotiations. Both of these books should provide you with some real tactics that you can begin putting into place today. And number five, you gotta avoid distractions. Distractions in this business are gonna be your worst enemy. That's gonna be what's gonna derail you from actually doing the work that's gonna help you continue to be successful and earn a living in real estate. When you're feeling anxious about the whole commission lawsuit, do me a favor, reach out and talk to a past client. When you see another news article come out that talks about the commission lawsuits and potential effects, why don't you stop, post a video to social media and explaining the importance of the services that you provide to your clients. Remember, your personal feelings about how unfair it is or about feeling sorry for yourself translate into zero value for your client. Never forget that the agents that are willing to do the work and serve their clients at the highest level possible, they're the ones that are gonna last within the industry. Stop getting distracted by things out of your control and start concentrating on what is within your control. Like thinking about how you can better serve your client or explain how your services are not gonna diminish because of the verdict, rather how your services are gonna increase and enhance your next buyer client's transaction and experience working with you. Then spend your time living up to your own expectations. Well, that's it for today's quick Broker Corner update. I hope you guys got something out of it. If you did, please be sure to like the video, give me a comment, or even subscribe to our channel. Thanks again.